In this lesson, I'm going to talk about writing JavaScript code with brackets. I want to show you how nice the code hinting is for JavaScript, and I also want to talk about the built-in linting that happens when you write JavaScript code. I'm going to add one final line of code to my main.js file. I want a way to collapse all the shortcuts that have been revealed at one time. I'll make that happen if you click on the H1. I'll use jQuery to help me with this. I'll start by typing a dollar sign with an opening parentheses. The second parenthesis is added since I have auto close braces turned on. It's telling me what I should type next with this hint right here. Notice that string selector is in bold, so that's the first thing I need to type. I'll type H1. Then I'll add a period after the parentheses. Notice it's giving me all the jQuery methods that I can perform on a jQuery object in my hints. I want to use on, and I'll type parentheses again. Now it's telling me what parameters I need to provide for this method. First, I need to tell it what events I want to listen for, and it's telling me it's expecting a string. I'll type click. Now the second parameter is highlighted. What function do I want to execute when the event happens? I can type an anonymous function here, or I can reference an existing function. I want to hide all, so I'll start typing and use autocomplete to finish. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to type hide all on its own line with parentheses. When I do that, it tells me no parameter because that function does not expect any arguments. If I add a parameter to the function definition above, it will prompt me for one. So the code hinting with JavaScript is really nice if you pay attention to it. Sometimes when you're writing code, you don't necessarily look at what's happening on the screen, but these code hints can help you remember the syntax while you're typing. Notice that there's a little dot right now next to the live preview button. If I hover, it tells me I need to save the file to refresh. That's because changes to the JavaScript files are not reflected in live preview until you save your file. HTML and CSS changes are reflected immediately, but you need to save JavaScript. That's a good thing because your code would be broken while you're typing. If I click on the header, the shortcuts and notes are collapsed now. This is not a great design, and I'll probably come up with something different for my final version, but I just wanted to demonstrate the code hinting today. I also want to talk about the JavaScript linting that brackets is doing when I save my file. If we look at the bottom of the screen, I have this warning symbol that's indicating I have errors. If I hover, it'll tell me I have 11 errors. I can click on the icon and it will open the linting panel. It's using the JS Lint engine to find errors, and JS Lint is pretty strict. When I first started using brackets, I was not much of a JavaScript programmer. I was mostly just using bits of jQuery on my websites, and I found this linting panel annoying. My code worked, and I didn't want to see those errors. You can turn off the linting through the View menu by unchecking Lint Files on Save. However, I don't recommend that because there's a lot to be learned from exploring these warnings. I've come to love the linting panel now. It's taught me things about JavaScript that I might not have learned as quickly if I wasn't paying attention. It's also caught many syntax errors that would cause problems in my code and would have taken some debugging if I hadn't been warned right away. Another nice thing about linting your code is that you can enforce some style rules to keep your code style consistent. I leave it open all the time now because it catches problems whenever I save my code. You can keep it closed if it's getting in the way by clicking on the X or using the icon to toggle it open and closed. You'll still get the warnings, but you toggle the panel to see them. One nice website to use when you're first learning what these linting errors mean and what to do about them is jslinterrors.com. If you type in part of the message, it will give you some guidance on what the errors mean and how to fix the problem. I know the first error is because I don't have use strict inside my function definition. I'll add that, save, and the error goes away. This next one is because I don't have a space before my parentheses after the function. If I add the space and save, you can see it go away, but I don't like that style for my code. If I look for that error on the website, it's telling me I can set the white option to true. I could put this little comment in my code to override the error right here, but I don't want to do that. I really want to set my preferences to ignore those white space differences. I'm going to wait to do that until the next lesson when I talk about the brackets preferences. For now, I'm just going to ignore those errors in the linting panel. This error is telling me to combine my vars into one statement. I'm going to ignore that one also. This next one I do care about. Unexpected space is because there's a space at the end of the line. I don't like those extra spaces and I want them removed when I commit things to Git. I use an extension to strip those trailing spaces and I'll show you that in my extension lesson, which will be coming up very soon. For now, I'll delete those extra spaces manually everywhere they were found. I also want to fix this missing space error because I do like a space before the brackets. This last error is not really a problem because jQuery was saved as a global object when it was loaded, so we do have access to it. This type of error is useful, however, because there are plenty of times you might mistype something and the linter will tell you that you're referencing something that's not defined. Say I try to call a function that I haven't written yet. It tells me I'm using it before it was defined, and that's good to know. I either mistyped it or I need to write the function still. The linting panel is nice because you're getting instant feedback when you save your file. As I said, I can set my preferences not to worry about these remaining errors through the brackets preferences file. I'll cover how to do that in the next lesson.